Iris Commander offers us different tools to work with layers. From the workspace drafting and annotation, we have the section layers and their respective tools. We will also find them in the workspace 3D modeling. However, now we have a new option, which allows us to open the Layers Manager as a palette. This palette can be floating in addition to being able to manipulate its shape and place it anywhere on the screen. If we work with more than one monitor, we can place the Layers Manager palette in another of them and thus free up the workspace. We can also drag and incorporate it with the other palettes and thus locate the tab in the position that we want. Also, as it is a palette, we can make it hide when we move the mouse away from that area, and it emerges again when we position the mouse over it, making the drawing area freer. To leave this palette floating, we just have to drag it from the edge and drop it anywhere. Note that we can also anchor it on the opposite side to the rest of the palettes, to have, for example, the layers and the properties open and visible. Of course, we can make both palettes close when the mouse is out of the area, no matter the workspace in which we're working. At some point, we may need to create a new layer that is off in all viewports. Iris Commander offers us a specific tool for this that we will find within the Layers Manager and will serve us, for example, to create an auxiliary layer in which to create 2D or 3D objects and thus prevent them from appearing by mistake within a viewport. In this way, the new layer is created off by default. Therefore, if we now make our new layer the active one, we will be able to build entities without being visible in the viewport. This saves us a lot of work, since it prevents us from accidentally showing parts of the drawing in places where we do not want it. In turn, the Layers Manager offers other tools. For example, the first with which we'll be able to create new layers. This other tool will allow us to eliminate layers, although they must meet certain conditions, such as being empty of entities, that is not the active, that's not the layer 0 or def point, or that is referenced with some other type of object. In short, the same conditions that are needed to eliminate layers with the purge command. The merge tool allows us to merge layers, and it's a theme that we'll see in another video. This other icon will allow us to convert a layer into the active layer. In turn, this other allows us to open the layer states, and also find a video that talks about how to create and configure layer states to be able to even save it and export it to other drawings. The command layer preview allows us to have a preview of the entities that belong to one or more layers. Watch. When using it, you will first see selected the visible layers of the drawing. Now, if you select layers one by one, you'll be able to see which entities belong to each of them. Alternatively, you can select multiple layers by holding down the Control key. Or click on one of the layers and keep the Shift key pressed to choose another layer, and thus select all of those that are between them. Also noteworthy is the filter, which allows us to search for layers that begin with a combination of letters followed by an asterisk, showing all the layers that match these conditions. If we want to search for layers that end with the letters ER, we can write asterisk followed by ER and search for all the layers that match this new condition. With this other icon, we'll be able to activate the layer filters creating groups and conditions to be able to quickly make selections of layers according to the filters we have made, and that we will also see in another video. To learn more about the tools related to layers in Ares Commander, be sure to visit the extensive help offered by the software.